SpaceX has given us a real early glimpse. The latest Raptor 3 test served as a preview of what's to come, showcasing some significant improvements to the updated engine. What can we expect from these upcoming developments? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. The B-18 incident has undoubtedly disappointed some, as without that setback, we might have already seen the arrival of the first Raptor 3 engine at the production site. Despite this, development continues. S-39 is being prepared for transport, and after completing its cryogenic test suite, the engine will be installed. This is why SpaceX has begun detailing the procedures associated with the Raptor 3 initiative in greater detail. Recently, SpaceX shared key information regarding its latest Raptor 3 test conducted at the McGregor facility. This 6-minute, 40-second video provides one of the most comprehensive insights we've ever gotten into the operation of the next-generation Raptor engine. The video begins with the ignition sequence, progresses to a long burn featuring active gimbal movement, and concludes with a smooth shutdown. The footage alternates between various angles, including close-ups, wide-angle shots, and views outside the stand, showing how the engines react under varying conditions. While SpaceX hasn't detailed the details, the test appears to involve a single Raptor 3. If accurate, it's clearly a long-term assessment intended to validate the engine's ability to function continuously for an extended period. SpaceX reinforced this idea in an update accompanying the video, stating validation test on a Raptor 3 performing a Starship V3 ascent burn. This phrase makes the point clear. The test aims to replicate the most demanding segment of powered flight, which occurs during the ascent phase. During this phase, all engines operate at maximum capacity. For a super heavy vehicle, all 33 engines must fire at full power to propel the massive booster through the densest part of the atmosphere. Later phases require fewer engines, but the initial ascent is the most stressful period. The same is true for the vehicle. Its sea-level engines must operate at full throttle immediately after stage separation, while the re-entry phase relies on only 3 engines. The climb is the most energy-demanding segment of the journey, because the spacecraft must counteract both gravitational pull and atmospheric resistance simultaneously. This is precisely why the climb phase holds such significance for V3. SpaceX aims for Starship V3 to successfully enter orbit, a goal that V1 and V2 were not built to achieve. Reaching orbit necessitates an engine that is not only powerful, but also dependable for several minutes of continuous operation. If the engine fails to deliver consistent performance during that time frame, Starship might not attain the necessary orbital speed or could use more fuel than anticipated, potentially jeopardizing the mission's goals. Naturally, actual spaceflight is much more intricate than a controlled test burn on the ground. Engines do not function in isolation. When in operation together, they generate considerably higher heat, stronger vibrations, and notable exhaust interactions. These combined elements can influence performance in ways that cannot be perfectly duplicated in isolated experiments. This emphasizes the importance of integrated system testing. Nonetheless, tests like this instill confidence that Raptor 3 is progressing toward fulfilling its operational criteria. The nearly 7-minute burn depicted in the video is highly encouraging. To contextualize, a complete super heavy ascent only takes 6 to 8 minutes, with approximately 2.5 minutes at peak power. Raptor 3 executing such a lengthy burn under test stand circumstances marks a significant achievement. It shows that the engine is capable of the sustained efficiency required for actual missions, particularly for the center engines that endure the greatest strain. SpaceX underscored this point in the update by indicating that various iterations of this test will simulate the different conditions experienced by Starship's 3 inner engines during its initial ascent into space. The center engines differ from the outer ring engines present on Super Heavy and the vacuum engines on the spacecraft. They deliver essential thrust while also managing navigation due to their gimbal capability. This is why the video demonstrates the engine moving back and forth while firing. SpaceX is likely assessing if the engine can sustain stable combustion while navigating through a broad range of steering angles. However, additional tests must be conducted before Raptor 3 is completely validated for flight. Among the most critical will be the multiple restart test campaign. The center engines experience various on and off cycles throughout a mission. On Super Heavy, the center engines cease operation after liftoff, restart for the boost back burn, shut down again, and then reignite during the landing burn. The spacecraft will execute another restart in orbit as part of its relight test and subsequently for operational activities like payload deployment. This continuous start and stop cycle is known to pose challenges, so SpaceX conducted extensive testing on the Raptor 3. Another key aspect was gimbal stress testing. In a real-life flight scenario, the engines must pivot sharply to adjust to winds, changes in weight distribution, and rapid movements. The test facility allowed SpaceX to push the gimbals beyond standard flight limits to verify their performance and control under extreme conditions. Collectively, these Raptor 3 evaluations demonstrate the breadth of modifications introduced to Starship V3. This latest iteration is designed for a much more complex mission than previous prototypes. Objectives include achieving orbit, deploying cargo, and executing a planned landing. Increasing thrust alone is not enough. The engines must be able to withstand prolonged burns, survive re-entry, manage multiple restarts, and provide accurate guidance. The Raptor 3 evaluation at McGregor demonstrates SpaceX's rigorous efforts to achieve this comprehensive suite of capabilities. Once this separate testing is complete, the next key objective is an integrated static fire demonstration. This evaluation will illustrate how the Raptor 3 operates when installed on a live stage with all 33 engines firing simultaneously on the Super Heavy. The anticipated thrust exceeding 9,000 tons will be one of the most impressive displays in the history of rocket propulsion. Furthermore, this test will highlight how the engine handles heat buildup, exhaust gas interactions, and structural vibrations. In terms of hardware development, the S-39 has completed production and is expected to begin testing soon, likely in the first half of this month. After cryogenic evaluation, the S-39 will be transferred to a production facility for engine installation. If progress continues at its current pace, the Raptor 3 engine will likely be integrated into the S-39 in the second half of this month. This suggests a static burn attempt could likely occur before the end of the year. Super Heavy is slightly behind schedule. The B-19 is still in the build-up phase, and this effort will likely continue through the end of the month. Early next year, the S-39 will begin its series of cryogenic tests. If all goes well, the Raptor 3 engine will likely be installed on the B-19 in mid-January, with 33 engines ready for static operation by the second half of this month. This target may seem far-fetched, but we are already in December. From now on, the Raptor 3 and Starship V3 launches will begin in rapid succession. The engine test shared by SpaceX is just a glimpse of the incredible performance to come. Are you ready for what's to come? If you're excited for V3's arrival, please comment "Welcome V3" below. Also, be sure to like the video and subscribe to stay updated on every phase of SpaceX's next monumental progress. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next time.